Hello and welcome back to Diablo 3. In the last episode, you saw us finally manage to do the 4 minutes to save the world stage of the Conqueror season journey. We are going to be carrying on with rifts for this session. Alex still needs to get more legendary gems ranked up, so we're not going to be carrying on with our own season journey this time. We are not wasting the time though. We're going to be putting things into Caldesan's Despair. So we just need to rank the gems up to at least 30 to go into a weapon, at least 40 to go into one of our rings, or at least 50 to go into one of our pieces of armor. Probably going to be aiming for 50. Throw on the Aquila Cuirass. I think that's a pretty safe bet to start with. But first of all, we need to hit the rifts. Alex.
Yes.
Greater rift.
Let's do a greater rift. Are you happy to stay at Torment 10, or do you want to bump it up to like level 46?
Whatever you need is good with me, because don't forget I am leagues ahead. You're
working on the lower gems anyway. Well, we'll put it up a little bit and see how scared I get.
And I'm no longer speed rift build, so I'm going to be much closer to you throughout.
Well, I think that's good. Ooh, frozen. Wait, does that also mean you're potentially getting frozen by stuff?
What do you mean?
Well, before you used to just ignore frozens.
And, I still ignore them. I mean, I was never immune to them, I just ignored them, because I didn't really care. That hasn't changed.
Still have the survivability of a pack for it.
Yeah, kind of. Conduit.
Ooh, nice. Ooh. Yeah. Molten and general explodey things. I actually saw your health dip there.
Yep, it does that from time to time. Since my build has evolved over time, I've decided that things like I don't need an energy shield.
Yeah, so your health can just go up and down. At some point I will change off the molten wildebeest gizzard that I'm using, but I think I need a lot more general vitality before I do that. Because at the moment, it does add a good, 20% life equivalent in a shield.
It's a good thing nothing shield has, shield penetration.
Yes, except for just, hitting for an absolute ton.
Yes, except, just brute force.
But because the shield comes back faster than my health comes back, it's quite a good thing, and modern wildebeest gizzard adds, of course, to my just general regen. But eventually I'll change it over for perhaps the Enforcer one, that increases your pet's
survivability.
I think it's damage as well.
It's probably both.
Next area. Power pylon. Wow. 4,295 million. And that wasn't even a big one. I reckon it can get to over 6,000.
Yeah, I just got almost 9,000 million.
Of course you did. You are 100 Paragon levels ahead of me, so...
That doesn't make that much difference.
Plus the equivalent gaming for general equipment and everything else that goes with it.
Yeah, I suppose.
And this one is a pig. It's going to be very weird next season when I change over to being a barbarian, being in the thick of it all and not, or probably not worrying too much about survivability.
I'm anticipating many deaths for you.
Well, that's just traditional. I might start there naming them like the first, the second, the third. And...
You'll have to pick gender-neutral names like Sam.
Francis.
Rory.
Dude. So glad that we managed to get that riff done in 4 minutes.
Yep, me
just
too.
Knowing that when I reach that point in the season journey that I won't need to worry about it.
Yeah.
The rest of it can, you know, you can just hammer at it until you get to it, but that as an actual time limit is a horrible time limit.
Yeah, it's just a good job it doesn't need to be done solo.
Yes. Well, even if it did, you'd probably be fine. I wouldn't. I'm pretty certain that there are speed builds for Witch Doctors, but I've got no idea how they would play. I still barely know how this character plays.
You're playing a character? Yes, this invoker set kind of feels like Crusaders were always supposed to play.
Or just charging in and let everything die on you.
Like, wow, right, how... in the thick of it. Like, really, really survivable. Not a huge amount of damage in bursts, just like...
Yeah. Rift Guardian time. Right on me. I instantly ran away from my wall of death.
Yeah, I would.
Well, that's a good stack of uniques. Grab all of them. And Urshi. Not let's grab Urshi, but let's talk to Urshi. Alright, Gem of Vapacious Toxin is 45. And Bane of the Trapped is 44, so I need one... We could do it in one more greater rift. Alas, I don't have any greater of keystones, so we do need to run a regular. It looks like I got some interesting uniques. Let's ID these very quickly. Mortal Drama, that sounds like a cool thing. What was that?
Oh, that doubles the number of bombardment impacts. I have that in my cube already.
Flesh Terror. Coils of the First Spider. While channeling Fire Bats, I gain 30% damage reduction and 7,000 life per hit. That's quite nice.
Yeah.
Unexpected for Fire Bats, but...
That's almost near the maximum for the life per hit, by the way.
Yeah, 80,000 is the maximum. That is too expensive. Because I've got the Staff of Chiroptera cubed as well. That could be an interesting one. So I'm going to put that in with everything else that I'm just holding on to in case it one day becomes useful. I should probably take the gem out of Gazing Demise now, I think. But no, let's leave it in there. We can salvage this, we can salvage Flesh Terror, we can salvage the other Gazing Demise, and we can salvage Sever, because I think I have one ready to go, yeah. Alright. Hadrig, you can take all of these things. This... Break them apart, break them apart. It's good that you can find more than one of the same type of unique in the game.
Yes.
Otherwise, it would be very specific decisions of how do I use these materials. Arrogant points. This was going to go into resource cost reduction.
So just regular Nephilim rifts?
Yes. A regular Nephilim lift.
Yep. I can start collecting death breaths at a nice leisurely pace.
Power pylon, let's go quick. Let's see if we can do it 3 minutes.
Wasn't that a shield pylon?
It was. So what? I wasn't reading, it said power claimed.
I mean, it's a good job that it was, given that you just charged into this pack, assuming that you would kill them quite quickly.
I did kill them quite quickly.
Hey, 2 uniques already.
What? No, that's wrong.
No, it's very right.
Rakov's got... Wait, you're actually stopping to ID them.
Hey, no time pressure, right?
So much for let's do it in 3 minutes. I mean, what are you going to do when you finish your conquest thing?
What sort of idiot said let's do it in 3 minutes?
Hey! I'm not an idiot. The not sort of idiot. That's the sort. Although, the rifts that we are plowing through at the moment do make me think about the survivability of my mobs, because the Gargantuans have died a couple of times. And it could be that I need to start looking into pet survivability in order to keep my progress fast for the other rifts, especially if I'm going to be trying to get to greater rift 50 by myself.
Yeah, that's always a concern.
But not for you, it's not, because you don't have pets or friends.
No. I got a Templar, he sort of follows me around. I gave him a thing, which means he can't die, and then I rolled off vitality and plus life on everything he owns.
So it's basically indentured servitude for him.
Yeah.
You can't die, you know, just tolerate the torture.
He seems to like it though, so it's alright.
Good, kill them before the orbiters really take effect.
Yeah, it's nice that you get a small amount of wind-up warning. What's that shrine?
Frenzy, so we attack a little bit faster, but not really worth commenting on. Yeah, I wonder if increased attack speed affects my zombie dogs and the like.
Should do. It should just
Because I always
like...
get the...
I was going to say it should be an extrapolation of their damage.
Yeah, I always get the feeling that they spend a lot of their time running between mobs. So I never feel like increased attack speed is massively beneficial unless I'm playing a melee character. Or a wizard with chain lightning. Ooh, Dem Hoarder. See you just chasing him down with bombards.
Little bastard.
Right, I'm moving on.
I ran back for the other gems. Ah, oh, the Pandemonium Fortress.
I love this place!
It is actually one of my favourite places. Mostly because I've got such good memories of you dying in here.
I've got amusing memories of me dying here, and I've got battle nets screwed up more than once memories of me dying here, and mostly I have a very healthy respect for Malfion.
Yes, I just remember back to that first time that we were really pushing the season journey, and we thought, yeah. You know...
And we jumped up to Torment 7, wasn't it?
Yeah, how much harder can Torment 7 be over Torment 5? Really?
Really? It could be really that much harder, and not only that, Malfiel is like an entire Torment level higher than everything else.
Yeah, because we just did them on Torment 4, and we thought, oh well, we'll do them on Torment 5, and that was fine. And then we were like, should we go to 6? Nah, let's go 7.
No. It's like, not quite one-shotted, but at the same time, not enough time to run between the healing fountains before you die.
I'm pretty sure you got one-shotted, and then I died very, very shortly afterwards.
You survived quite well, though. I think it was your dodge that was keeping you alive, who I've just lost a life, so I'm backing off. Shoot the weapon rack while I'm here. I'm contributing, I'm shooting over a gap that they can't reach me from. I can't get my wall of death over it, so it's just my spirit barrage, and it's not even the main spirit barrage, it's the extra bits.
That's just silly. Oh yeah, I can see it sort of affecting them.
There we go, killed one. There we go.
Thanks for your moral support.
My life is back, so I'm back in the game. There's like four death breaths in the middle of that.
Yep, that's because there was a blue pack and a yellow in the middle of him.
Good times. Always good when the area of effect bombardment can kill many things at once.
Yeah, but my bombard doesn't really do most of my damage.
Now, most of your damage is done by other things attacking you.
Actually, it's kind of done by the invoker set, just like as a passive side ability of me just punching things. So the punch doesn't do damage. Neither does anything like really hitting me. I mean, it kind of does a bit, but that's not where the most of it comes from. Done.
Two greater rift keystones. Perfect. And one unique chest armor.
Come on then, give me another couple of boots.
No. This looks like Tyrael's stuff.
Is it horribly blue?
It is. And the short man's finger. Which is not better than my current one, despite the fact that my current one has a socket in it. Okay, well, let's salvage both of them up. And with 408 blood shards, Kadala, give me some helmets, please. None of these are Jerems. None of these are good at all. Adric, take all of these things off me.
Not ready yet.
Okay, well, with the two greater rift keystones, that should almost certainly get me to the three gems at 45, which I... Oh, I should have held on to that short man's finger, actually, to potentially re-roll it into an ancient one. Oh well. Too late, as
I'm
they
sure
say.
Sure, you'll find another one.
Yes. Are you ready for a greater rift?
Sure.
I love the insanity when you enter a rift for the first time. Sometimes it's fine, and sometimes it's like, oh my god, what happened to the screen?
Do you mean specifically when I enter?
No, just anyone. Me, you. Our viewers at home. Or in the office if they're watching at work, in which case bad people, but good people.
They might be waiting for their code to compile.
Or lunch break, or you know, just skiving off. waiting for minions to do their work for them. Delegation. Part of good business. So glad that I didn't stop directly on that flame pit thing. That flame bellows. I was like, oh, I'm quite close to it, and then it just started breathing and it missed me by like an inch.
Oh, this rift is stupid. It's just boggarts and nothing big.
Just like the mobs from this rift.
Hey, Paragon 500.
Oh, very well done. You're only 93 Paragon levels ahead of me now.
Even newer Paragon portrait. Love when I run on my horse and my little pet has to quadruple time it to keep up.
hot footing master.
Hey, I found a blue boggart.
Well, once again, you passed me and I didn't actually see you on my screen at all. I could have just been me not being observant, but at the same time,
I wasn't on my horse, I just walked past you.
Ah. I just missed you in the crowd then.
I suppose you missed all the barrels and stuff that were coming down.
Yes, this is not a particularly fast rift, is it?
Shield pylon.
Coming down towards you. And while the shield pylon is on, stand in the middle of the mortar horde. Okay, not that way. Back we go. Must be up this way.
Yes.
That time I saw you walk through. It is easy to miss you though, if it's at one of the few points when you're not just accidentally dropping barrels from the sky. You're quite nondescript.
Yep. Stealth Crusader. I'm in the next area, by the way.
I'm here as well. For a moment, I thought you'd already found the way onto the next area. Paragon 408. Channeling
pylon.
Oh, cool. All of the grasping of the dead stuff. All of the wall of death.
Pretty much means I just start mashing my keyboard.
There is a lot of zombies just grasping the ground.
Time in a second.
very nearly there. If I'm lucky, which I probably won't be, then I'll complete it this time. But if not, we do have another gemstone to go straight back in.
Hey, Raziel.
Hey, Raziel. How's it hanging? Ring, amulet, sword, enchantress focus, voodoo mask. Okay, gem time. One failed. One succeed. One succeed. One fail. So I just need two more and I'll be golden.
Paragon 501.
Paragon 409 for me. Alright, I got three Paragon levels in that, so that's one, two, three. Wrath of the Bone King looks so pretty, but it's just such an unimpressive thing.
Yeah, it's like a big version of the Mad Monarch Scepter.
Yeah. Pingium, that's an interesting one. Useful if I had stuff that was really reliant on there.
Do you have it cubed yet?
I do. Do you want it?
I found it.
Okay.
As in, I also got one just then.
Oh, right. I wasn't looking at your stuff, I was only looking at mine.
Because you referred to my Wrath of the Bone King host.
Yeah, because it was ancient. It stood out. I wasn't really paying attention. Helm.
Boots.
Two spit tusks, one worse than the other. Oh, you got two Roland strides, one worse than the other. Okay, that's all of them salvaged. And I am ready to go back in if you are.
I am.
Stepping up one level. Well, this is, it's quite good for me to test this, because if I can survive these mobs in a two-player, then I should be able to survive them by myself, even if I'm going slower through the whole lot of them.
Yes. That does make some sense. I mean, you might not be able to kill them in time, but you'll be able to survive them, as he calls
yeah.
it.
And my killing speed will improve with my Paragon levels and as my equipment gets better. Is it not the other way then?
Nope. There is nothing up there but war. And now some bodies.
Good to know. I think once we're done with this rift, I'll take a look at the Enforcer gem and see what it actually does. Could be good.
Oh,
the zombies. I heading up towards you then. And dodging minor explosions. Okay, 40% through this time. Hiding them behind a wall, indeed.
Yeah.
Little bit rude. No, you can't have my purple globes.
Right, Russians.
Thank you, Paragon 410. I feel like I'm almost racing along today.
See, that's why I've had such a high Paragon level in comparison to you, is because the amount of XP you get on higher things, it just really ramps you up.
Oh yeah, it's just the ability to survive at the higher levels that determines whether you can actually do that.
Yeah. Your pylon.
Your pylon hits, Alex runs into the middle of everything. Just about a third left of the shield pylon. Not that you care about it.
Hey, Paragon 580. Power pylon.
All of a sudden everything starts doing a hell of a lot more damage.
You mean actually starts doing damage?
I know, it was doing damage before.
With a shield pylon?
Hmm?
With a shield pylon on?
Power pylon.
We had a shield pylon on just before the power pylon.
Yeah, yeah. But then you put the power pylon on and I noticed everything was starting to die a lot more.
Right, I thought you meant all the monsters were starting to do a lot more damage. I was like, because the shield pylon just ran out.
No, I meant I was killing things. Not they were killing things. Very nearly Rift Guardian time.
Like, I don't want to pop my abilities to kill things here faster.
Yeah. Bang. Okay. See what we've got here. Okay, Urshi. Model Wildebeest Gizzard. And Gizzard. That's 3 to 45, which didn't announce anything, but let's double check. It has ticked it off. All right, and the other one, I guess, let's put it in the Gem of Toxin. Ah, it didn't work. Put it in the Gem of Toxin. There we go. Okay, let's assign those Paragon points that I got. Critical hit chance and extra arm. Right, all in all, I consider that to be pretty darn successful. What did we get from this? We got Full Man's Finger again, Hellcat Waste Guard, Bottomless Potion of Fear, Ring of Ears, and so these are all going to get salvaged. That's going to get.
I got some potentially marginally better shoes.
Hooray for extra shoes. Alright, yeah, let's get some helmets from Kadala. That is ever so slightly better than what I'm using, and it actually improves Spirit Barrage, which I'm already using. So I'm going to switch over to that. Lovely. All right, then take the gem out of this.
No, they're not better.
Put it in this one.
Because they've already got a different sort of resist on them.
I need to change the way it looks, though, so that it suits my proper attire. Right, transmogrify. There's Carnival. And let's get some dye for it as well. Oh, not from Shen. Ooh, it doesn't have the one that I wanted.
Well, there are plenty of other vendors.
No, we're going with the first one. We're going to just make it red. That'll do. Okay, well, I think that's probably a good point for us to finish this evening. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed the step through of the season journey that we've been doing. No doubt we'll be back next week for more Diablo 3 as part of Monday Night Gaming, and hopefully we'll finish off the Destroyer level for me and move on to the Conqueror level, which Matrix is already working through. Either way, hope to see you soon.